I do that long enough, Doug Bradley will appear.
So what we are doing is sculpting an idea for a makeup for this new version of Hellraiser. Look, let's cut to the chase. Clive's original design is perfect for me. It's a brilliant, brilliant design, and I'd like to see the film carry that design on. I mean, I think it's the reason the Hellraiser films are successful is because of Pinhead, you know? I mean, it's just a brilliant design, and Doug's brilliant in it, and shouldn't change. It should be exactly the same. This film, for good or bad, is going to be very different, I think. And I've got two choices. I either embrace that and get the work, which I'd like, because I am a fan of Hellraiser, first and foremost. Or I turn my back on it and have nothing to do with it. So this will be a completely original rendering of what Pinhead would be in every way, in makeup and in costume and everything. It will be very different, very, very different, much more hardcore and different, just different, not so ordered. But ordered and very different. I'm changing all the facets that are the established pieces of it. First of all, for the face, since I'm not locked into it, I want to put some character into the actual structure of the face. I don't want to just do a round, like a layer of skin on top of the face. So I want to kind of just strengthen all the features upon it. And two actors I really love the features of are Peter Cushing and Ray Fiennes. So I'd like to try and push a little bit of Peter Cushing and Ray Fiennes in there. You can already see a bit of Peter Cushing in there, I think. I don't know if you can tell, but through the jaw and through the nose, there's a bit of Peter Cushing in there. So that's going to be the first thing, is to just kind of get some features into this sculpt. Then we'll do the rest of it, which is going to be different. I'm not going to give anything away yet. It's 6 a.m. in the morning. And Mike blocked out the other half of this. I'm normally not this much of an early bird. But I suddenly realised that I should document this. This is where the new grid's going to go on, and it's going to be very different. You can already see I've started to etch in some of the lines. It's a very different kind of grid. Based in part on some stuff that I do on the box. Or started doing on there. The main configuration. It's just a pattern that I kind of grow to like. So that's what I'm gonna do. Do you not? I feel like I'm betraying Doug.
Well, here's the thing. You're not betraying Doug. Unfortunately, in the reimagining of the film, the character of Pinhead, the character that Doug played, they've decided to go a different route with it. I think they're looking to change everything.
What do you think of this design? How do you think it compares?
I think it's unique. I think it's different, but I think it still has the flavor of the character to it.
Mike's last done with the sculpt, and now we're going to throw in some pins. I just want to see how it looks with the pins in it. And then Jeff will mold it tomorrow. Then we'll run one. Look at that. Isn't that bizarre? As I insert each pin, I can almost hear a cry of Hellraiser fans the world over going, "No! You're screwing with the icon! Don't do that!" It's Pinhead, but it's not, you know what I mean?
strange. Look, I mean, you're damned if you do and damned if you don't, aren't you? You know what I mean? So I've decided that this should be a very... I don't know, I just think if you're going to do it, if you're going to make something different, make it different. Don't play at it. Do it. As I spoke to someone today and I said, look, even if it means that they look at this and say, well, look, it's a horrible idea, let's go back to the original. Great. I'd be more than happy with that. I wish Doug could wear it. I think Doug should voice it. Even if Doug ends up doing a cameo, I think he should do something. I think if they do this HELLRAISER movie, if we're even involved. You might think this is a very yellow colour, and it is. But it'll be a good base for this new Pinhead, which is still going to kind of have some of the traditional colours to it. But even the old Pinhead was more of a fleshy colour than people actually think. And it's not blue, obviously. So we're going with a nice dark red. And I'm letting it go off the edge of the piece. We're going to fill this in with scab afterwards. Stick it on someone and we'll do a little thing and end up on YouTube for people to bitch about. For someone to say, whoa, cool, and then some asshole who's done nothing more than 3 videos of how to do coin tricks to say it sucks, you know, because I mean that's all they've got to do in their sad little lives, isn't it? You know, it's easy to stand there and say, oh, I don't like it, in their bedroom. You know, having done bugger all with their lives.